These are YTWs, nice little combination of movements to three-dimensionally strength train the shoulder. And start position on these, you can see I'm standing and just hinged at the waist, neck is neutral, and we want to really squeeze those shoulder blades together and try to hold that position. This first one is the Y, so I'm just moving my arms up, and we're going to change the angle in the front here with the camera so you can see both positions, but just trying to get those arms up all the way to the end range of motion of the shoulders. Thumbs are going to be pointing out in front of you, and then you're going to try to point those all the way up to the ceiling at the end range of motion. And you can see from this angle that the arms are moving out in a diagonal pattern, not just straight up in front of me, but also out to the side a little bit in what you would maybe call a Y. So again, make sure you keep that neck and head neutral, back nice and flat, and shoulder blades coming together. That was the Y. Next is the T. So arms are going to move out into a T this time. We're just lifting the arms straight out to the sides from the shoulder. Again, neck is neutral, head is neutral, abs are tight, shoulder blades are squeezing together. And we're just starting with the thumbs facing away from each other this time. So hands, palms facing away, thumbs facing away at the bottom of the movement. And then the thumb should be facing the ceiling at the top of the movement. I'll show you the same thing from the front here. So feet at hip width apart, we're going to hinge at the waist. Neck and head are neutral, shoulder blades squeezing together. Thumbs are facing away from each other, palms facing away from the body, and then at the top, we're going to try to get those thumbs to face the ceiling, perpendicular to the floor. Maintaining that neutral neck and head the whole time, shoulder blades together the whole time. That was the T. And the last one is a W. So again, same start position, we're hinging at the waist, flat back, head and neck are neutral, shoulder blades are coming together. Here we're going to start with our palms facing back towards our body, and we're going to bring our elbows and upper arms straight up until the upper arm is parallel to the ground, and then we're going to externally rotate the shoulder so that the lower part of the arm also becomes parallel to the ground. So lifting from the elbow and then rotating so that from the elbow to the hand becomes parallel to the ground. We'll show you the same thing from the front. Now you'll see here that my right shoulder, I'm having a little trouble with it. So it's kind of a what not to do on the right side there. You can see I'm lacking some mobility on that side. I've got a little injury in my right shoulder here. But just imagine what it would look like if that right arm was coming all the way up to parallel to match that left arm there. And so it's elbows first, and then we externally rotate and we get those forearms parallel to the floor as well.